Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. This is the man behind the mask. Over the weekend, governorship elections and senatorial elections were held in Kogi State and Bayelsa State. Here are the results filtering in so far. In Bayelsa, the candidate of the All Progressive Congress, APC, David Leon, has emerged winner of the governorship election held on Saturday. He won 6 of the state's 8 local governments, defeating his closest rival, Senator Doye Dili of the People's Democratic Party, PDP. This defeat marks the first time PDP will lose election in the state since 1999. INEC announced that APC pulled 352,552 votes to defeat PDP, who pulled 143,172 votes. Elsewhere in Kogi State, results from 19 out of 21 local government areas of the state have been declared, with Governor Bello leading his main challenger, Engineer Musa Wada of the PDP, with a margin of 205,942 votes. At this point, it is safe to declare Governor Bello as the winner of the Kogi governorship election. Meanwhile, the Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, has declared the senatorial election in Kogi West District inconclusive. Mr. Adeyemi is said to have scored 80,118 votes, while Mr. Mele pulled a total of 59,548 votes. Meanwhile, the number of registered voters in the areas where elections were cancelled is set to stand at 43,127. Hence, election declared inconclusive. It is also important to note that there were reports of voters' intimidation, ballot snatching, violence, and all sort of electoral irregularities. Having said that, let's quickly head to the comment section to see what Nigerians are saying. Our first comment comes from John Angels, and he said, "I think PDP in Bayelsa State saw this victory, hence their desperate act to use court to declare that APC has no candidate until another court set aside the earlier order. May the incoming governor see this victory as a tax to move the state forward and not to fight perceived and imaginary enemies." Next up is Obum Elkana, still making reference to APC win in Bayelsa. He says, "Political parties are like football teams. If you fail to play your best players against a stronger opponent, automatically you will lose the match." Still on the same matter, Zumji Yakubu says, "PDP make a great mistake for bringing unpopular candidate instead of Timi Alaibi." Alright, let's take some comment coming from Kogi State. Our first comment comes from Abba Musa, and he says, "Yahaya Bello will win Dekena, the PDP candidate's home, but PDP will not win Okene, Yahaya Bello's home. You people have no shame. Dekena is the largest local government in Nigeria, yet it can only record 25,000 votes for all the candidates, but Okene, the smallest, will give 112,000 votes. You people should fear God for once." Next up is Ijoma Joanne Osigwe, and she says, "No need to collate what you have already permuted. And the winner is Yeye Bello. Cheers, cool guys. Welcome to season 2. Pepe them." Alright, our last comment, also coming from Okene, is our Francis Friday JJ, and he says, "This is completely daylight robbery. If Angpa can produce 15,000 plus, then they should explain how on this earth Dekena, the largest local government, will produce just only 10,504. Devil in human skin everywhere." Thank you guys for watching 1/3 TV. for more educative and insightful videos on Nigeria and the world, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you want to be notified when we post new videos, please hit the bell button. Thank you. Alright guys, the election has come and gone. Those who are aggrieved, I believe, will head to the court. Let's try to keep things a bit peaceful. Let no man take laws into their hands. This is the man behind the man speaking. If you talk, democracy. If you don't talk, democracy. Let's talk and love. Until next time, peace out.